What I like about wine is if you get ever so slightly, you know, but it soon passes. Unlike beer, it sort of hangs around for a while. Ah, oh, I've had a very busy day. Cheers, everybody.
Cheers, Lou. My name is Myrtle Durham, and I'm 70 years old. I was born in Shipston-on-Stour in Warwickshire. I went to Shipston Primary School, and I didn't pass my 11 plus, unfortunately. And so I had to come to Vine and Secondary Model School. Later on, I became a head girl of the Vine and Secondary Model School. I stopped on an extra year to learn shorthand and typing, and which I did very well at. And I got a job later on as a shorthand typist for Morse's in Swindon. Then I got a job as a secretary to Harrods of London. And fortunately, I was earning more money than my husband.
My name is John Durham, and my age is 73. I was born in Great Coxwell near Farringdon, little village near Farringdon, and I lived in a small two up and two down with my mother and father and my five older sisters. Lots of memories, lots of happy memories.
We met at Shipping Memorial Hall. I had two friends, which were twins, and they were 6 foot tall. Because of me being only 5 foot four, I looked like a midget in comparison. So I was instantly taken with the fact that I was small. Though the men were sat over one side and all the ladies were sat over the other side.
You get across and, would you have this dance, please? No. So you then had to walk all the way back, whether she was tall, short, or what she was. She said no. So back you had to go, across the other, back to your mates who were laughing their socks off at your expense, to the other side of the hall again. So anyway, then this one opportunity came, and I spotted you between the two twins.
It was July the 2nd. 1966.
It was a fantastic day. It really was. I'd never thought I'd ever say it, but credit to your parents. I never got on very well with my in-laws, but I have to say they did a good job of the wedding day, which they saw to completely. I've no idea how many people there, but it must have been 60 or 70 people, yeah. Let's say. But it was a cracking day all round.
We went to. In a hired car, we went to Bournemouth, and we got
we busily got sunburnt on the very first Sunday, and so we had our nuptials on the Saturday night, but that was the end of that until we got back home. But it was a lovely time. We had a great time. What we didn't know then, of course, we courted for 3.5 years. We then had 7 short years of married life before my wife had her extremely serious life-threatening illness, which changed our lives completely.
We were living in Rorton, and my husband was at work and I was looking after 2 children, but I felt terrible, so I telephoned my husband and said, come home and look after the children while I go to bed. And then I don't remember anything else. Until 4.5 months later.
And the doctor came. I got the doctor who came and said, it's everywhere around Rorton. It's everybody's got the flu, and it's a bad dose of flu. What she had, in fact, was not a flu at all. It proved to be, in the end, a blood disorder. And I'll always remember it because it was... We had the very sort of a difficult night, and I woke up and she was, for the first time, because she hadn't been able to sleep, and there she was, absolutely fast asleep. I rang the doctor He said, well, I'm on my rounds and I'm coming your way, Artist Avenue, so I'll call in a bit later. I said, well, don't make it too soon, because she hasn't slept for a week, for days. So then this is her first good night's sleep. And in came the doctor, and he went upstairs, and I'm downstairs with the children. Eventually I go up and to see the doctor, and he was still with my wife. And he said, there's something seriously wrong. Your wife isn't asleep. She's unconscious.
I had a stroke. And I couldn't speak. I couldn't do anything. I couldn't move. I couldn't do anything. The stroke affected my right hand side. I've got no use in my right hand side. And it's affected my left eye. I'm blind in one eye. That's part of the, it is a part of, that's part of the stroke. But I've got curled up hand even now. My taste ducts have gone. I've got no, I can't cry. I can't even feel like crying. I feel so frightened. Tell you saying all these things. But I try very hard to do things, but I can't do them. I can't. It makes me very, very frustrated.
Those 3.5 years we spent, yes, they were a good, in that we were saving hard to buy our home and to get married. Every penny we had went in savings and, you know, to do that. But of course, little did we know that we would seven short years later, we'd have this massive problem, which changed everything. Everything. For a number of years. So we then began to look at those first 3.5 years as a complete waste of time. Get on with it. If you meet someone,
I should, yeah,
and you love them, get on with life. Because you just don't know.
It's always been there for me. In the mornings I have a bath, and I get in myself, I dry myself, I get dressed, do everything myself. But I know he's there. I would only have to do the slightest thing and he would be there.
From the day we met and the day we started, we danced, we just got on extremely well straight away. And we never looked back. It was the beginning of our romance and later our married life.
He's a very infectious person. And I just love him. I really, really love him.
What became just a close friendship grew quite soon into, and we were both absolutely sure that we loved each other from the outset. And certainly from within the few, 2 or 3 months, we were very much in love. And of course, I wanted to prove that to my in-laws by asking for Myrtle's hand in marriage.
But it's no good to worry, because it happens anyway. Life happens anyway. And you just got to get on with that. And make the most of what you've got. And live life to the full, as I intend, and I hope to do. What would I say to people if they have me and love me? I don't know where I would be without you. They've always been so lovely, and I think I don't give enough back. And tell them enough how much I'm grateful. But I am really, really grateful to them. Really grateful. I love you with all my heart.